May the Lord bless you guys. Evangelist Rob here of Rob Woods Ministries. I want to decree and declare to you, the camels are coming. The camels are coming. I went to do this show yesterday and I deleted it and tagged and titled the wrong show. My apologies. But once again, the camels are coming. What are the camels coming? What are they bringing? They're bringing prosperity, wealth, money, finances. God gives us provision for the vision. Now, I want you to listen to me. Don't buy into that religious stinking spirit where you're blessed if you're broke, busted, and disgusted. That's a religious spirit. I'm not a prosperity pimp. Well, I can't even say pimp. Praise the Lord. I don't come on here. I don't take offerings. People say, Rob, can I donate to your ministry? Can I sow? I tell them, find a missionary. Missionaries are the most humble vessels on the earth, the most contrite or a good pastor in a local church. I'm a business person. I'm an entrepreneur. My entire ministry is financed from my own pocket. That's just the way the Lord did it. May come one day where I have to may take offerings, but I've been on TV 10 years in New York. 7 secular stations, 49 shows a week preaching the gospel. It's all financed by me, and that's irrelevant. But friends, the camels are coming. Now, before I continue, I'm live again Mondays, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard. Mondays, 9 p.m. on YouTube, live. Come on. The chat's blowing up as I'm praying for people, as they're in the chat asking for prayer, direction, or word. Encouragement, exhortation. Everyone else is praying for the people I'm praying for, so there's breakthrough. And it also would be a great, great honor if you'd subscribe to my channel. If you're not, I want to pray finances, the windows of heaven to open for you, the impartation of the deluge of finances to come to you in 3-4 minutes. Now, let me take it into Isaiah chapter 60, verse 5, because the abundance of the sea shall be turned to you. The wealth of the Gentiles shall come to you. The multitudes of camels shall cover your land. The dromedaries of Midian and Ephah and those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and incense. Friends, the camels are coming. The camels brought gold, incense, myrrh. What do you think the three wise men brought to Jesus? They brought gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Each was costly in its own way, and they loaded the camels up, and the camels brought the gifts to Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, if you want to get blessed, you've got to learn how to be a sower. The Bible says God gives seed to the sower. Find the right ministries or minister that you feel connected with in covenant, and sow to them. Hallelujah. You know, the Lord will direct you. He'll show you. He'll give you the peace. Hallelujah. Now, I want to say this. The number one prayer request to any ministry you would think would be health, disease, infirmity, sickness, or relational. It's not. It's finances. The number one prayer request to any ministry is finances. And right now, we're still in the midst of the COVID. A lot of people are having a hard time. Some could be unemployed. Some could have businesses. They're not running numbers like they used to. But we've got to trust the God of finances. Now, Deuteronomy says he will give you power to get wealth. Another translation I like better is the Lord thy God that gives you power to create wealth. God's a creator, and he called you to be a creator of wealth. Over 95, almost 100% of people that win the lottery 6 months after they win are broke or even more broke than they were before they won, because they don't have the wisdom to steward and sustain and contain the thing that was entrusted to them. So it leaks and aborts out and it's wasted because they don't understand. Now, Solomon said, Lord, I don't want money. The Lord, God came to Solomon. Do you want money? No, I want wisdom. Because Solomon said this, I don't have the wisdom. When I get the wealth or money, it won't be sustained. So pray for wisdom. Now, let me say this. Never pray for money. Pray for wisdom and the strategy and the platform to learn how to create it. If you're a business person, you're an entrepreneur, Isaiah 22, it says, he opens doors no man can shut and shuts doors no man can open. Ask the Lord to open the door. But now let me say this. You've got to work. You understand? Money is not just going to fall on your doorstep, or angels aren't going to come and bring you. Now, of course, it's the Lord that brings us increase. It's the oxygen in our lungs that gives us the strength to do it all in all. But we've got to work. You got to work. You know, I started my business, man, pen and a calculator 30 years ago. I sometimes worked till 10, 11, 12, 1, 2 in the morning. In the morning. Yes, I worked on some Sundays after church. Because you got to do what you got to do. You understand what I'm saying? Well, you shouldn't work on the Sabbath, brother. I had a business to run. What do you want me to do around here? But that's when I could do certain things. It was that day where I would call people in to work, do work for me. Let's stop with the religion around here, guys. We got to stop. God wants you blessed so you can be a blessing. Father, I'm asking the camels to come to people. I'm asking the camels that when they were with the three wise men, they were laden and weighed down with gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Father, we don't want to be broke, busted, and disgusted. We want to be blessed so we can be a blessing. So I'm asking finances to come to my friends, anyone that's in need. Open the door. Give them wisdom in the mighty name of Jesus. Now think of Joseph when the Lord showed him there was going to be a famine, and he stored the grain and was able to feed the whole, you know, a lot of people, praise the Lord. So this is why we need finances to help others in a sense that are in this season that we're in. Hey, the Lord bless you guys. Subscribe to the channel. It'd be an honor. Again, I'm live every Monday, 9 p.m. on YouTube, prophesying the word of the Lord for an hour. Blessings in Jesus' name.